at this, see? Is that enough for you?
Brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King Lure Company, number one in fishing lures. Ardent, pure performance, all American. This week on Extreme Angler TV.
Like that. Look at a nice walleye. Oh, beautiful fish too. Look at him, eh? Hey, this week on the Cottage Angler, I'm gonna show you my 2-minute tip for dissecting a little pocket in the main lake.
We'll be right back.
Hey, welcome back to Extreme Angler. Early summer, another morning on a Kawartha Lakes looking for walleyes. And today I want to talk about the color of eyes. What colors do I use? What colors should you consider using? Two things come to mind, confidence and bait fish. I'm going to look what the forage is, perch, chub, bluegill, sunfish. What are those walleyes predominantly eating? Leeches and stuff like that. So I'm going to stick sometimes to black and silvers, browns with a little bit of green, perch tones, you name it. But the thing is, finding where they are and using the right colors that give you confidence. So if it's really choppy, I'll go to a heavier jig head, maybe a hair jig, jerk bait. If it's calm like this, and this to me, this is crystal calm, I'm gonna use a smaller jig head, have patience, let that bait fall down. I'm gonna try a couple different retrieves. The traditional cast, soft lift and drop, or to find those fish a bit more aggressively or find the bigger aggressive fish, I'm gonna cast out and do a slow retrieve. Just as if I'm bringing a big 6XD or 5XD along the bottom, just like you would for bass, okay? But finding fish, the sun gets real high, they start tucking the weeds a bit more, then I'll use traditional methods of putting it right inside the weeds. What I wanna get across is varying your color, having different selection of baits, rods, lines, things so you have variety. We're gonna do it here on Extreme Angler this week for walleye. You know, something to really consider about color and confidence and focusing on what you're doing. It could be from pike, muskie, smallmouth, crappie, it doesn't matter, but especially for the walleyes. I find that if I use something that they can see, a little bit of chartreuse, maybe some pink or some white, and then just contrast it with something with a little bit of smoke, a brown, a black, you know, yellow with black dots, pumpkin seed with a little bit of red, just something that they can look at. The contrasting colors. So a natural little tone looks like a minnow, perch, or a bluegill, whatever, and that little chartreuse, pink or white, to get their attention. And for me, it works. Like that. Look at a nice walleye. Oh, beautiful fish too, look at him, eh? Beautiful walleye, man. Look at that, eh? Just a gorgeous fish. Wow, eh? I went from a little point to just a little spot along a weed line. Look how we got it there too, eh? Wow, so cool, man. That fat little rage grub in the right spot. So I cut it down a little bit. Look at him. Just a gorgeous little fish. That's all just from a little vein or something, but look at, he's all fine. You're gonna go back. Thank you, my boy. Go on. See, move around a little bit. Came along this beginning of this weed line, went to the chartreuse, and I'm always experimenting. Just, you know, It was sunny, a little bit cloudy. And I'm pretty sure the sun's gonna come up, the chop's gonna come up a little bit, go back and forth, it just varies it up. So I've got different size of jig heads as well, and put on that little smoke with the blue, second cast. First I felt a little, and I just knew something was there, and all of a sudden they just load up on it. Let's keep going, hopefully get some real good ones. Put it out. And when I'm throwing the grub and following weed edges and stuff, I like to keep it close. Let it sink. Let it go down and down. It's a game of patience and waiting. Small twitch and just a steady retrieve. Just a slow retrieve. Once in a while, small little jerk, little twitch, maybe inspire bite. Nothing too radical. Just keep it real simple. As if you're drifting over a flat, trolling a crankbait. When your bait's in this stuff, you're gonna catch fish. You just gotta be patient. Look at this, it's just killer. It's a mix of milfoil and cabbage. You can't beat that combination. Stick with it, find the right color, and you're gonna catch these walleyes. Oh, pretty sure I got tagged right there. I don't know if it was a pike, it was up high. Weren't you biting there, hey? Nice little walleye, look at that, eh? See, it's giving up color. Look at that, eh? It is all about making the right choices. Look how nice. Look at that, eh? Look at that, just a gorgeous, weed-dwelling Kawartha walleye. Not touching the gills. And look where he got it. Look at that bait. He almost can't even see it down there. Those bites you rarely miss, eh? It's that traditional walleye tick, but it's about easy now, picking the right colors, the right choices of jig sizes, and that's the results. Picking the right size and the right depth, the right bait colors, matching the right rods and reels, that's really what it's all about in walleye fishing. There's no reason to be intimidated by them. They're just, they slow down, but when they're on a bite, anybody can catch them with any color, any device, heavier jig, lighter jig. But when they're not really aggressive, you know, it's late morning now and I'm moving around, I might find some fish that are really on the feed still, but it's a little late periods that guys traditionally go out to get those fish, go back in the cottage and chill out or go home. But what we're gonna do today is figure out different colors for walleyes based on the color of the water, the depth you're fishing, and the jig choices you use. Let's keep going. How do you know what size of jig head to use and stuff? Well, when it's calm like this, I call this calm, because I'll fish walleyes in 3 and 4 foot chop. You know, if it's safe and I can get out there, I'll rip bucktails, throw jerk baits, throw rattle baits and stuff like that. Get that real aggressive bite. But when it's like this, I still call this slick. Those walleyes are still feeding. You're still gonna catch them, but you just gotta tone it down a bit. I know a lot of guys like to use a bigger jig heads and stuff so they can feel the bottom. You know what? That's a fallacy. For me, the smaller the bait and the jig head I can get away with, the better. You're still gonna catch bigger size fish. And yes, you upgrade a bit, you'll eliminate some of that smaller bite. But walleye is notorious. Coming up, looking at it, sucking it in. So what I like to do is use a smaller jig head so I stay inside that strike zone, you know, where the fish are feeding. If I'm in 10 feet of water, they could be down 5 feet to eight, you know, 4 to 9, and whatever it is, it's between there. But the thing is, I wanna keep it relative to what I'm fishing, weeds, rocks, etc. I wanna just keep that bait in that fish's zone where he can see it. You know, they will eat off the bottom. They'll pick it up, you know, that's just the way they are in nature. They'll just find things to eat and they'll get it, like mayflies, etc. But when I'm fishing a grub or a tube or little baits like this, I want that bait to stay in that zone. So if they're swimming around, they see something falling, looks like a minnow, maybe dying, whoom, they come over, they can suck it in. So vary the size of jig heads depending on the weather conditions, the wave activity, and obviously the color of the water. See, told ya. Oh, it feels like a good fish too. You a big walleye? If you're a walleye, you're pretty big. I can tell you that much. Gotta get you out of the weeds. Let's see. Oh, I think it's a northern. Oh, a beautiful big pick. Look at him, eh? Just a beautiful walleye. Look at this thing. Wow, eh? I almost thought it was a pike. It ate it so good. Look at him. Whoa, easy, I know. I know what you're thinking. that little cast out and retrieve. You can use all different techniques, but man, oh man, when you're throwing that jig, that little grub, right in the nose there, he's safe too. Actually, he's over the slot too. I'm gonna put him in there for a picture by picking the right colors. The right color, right presentation, on the right spots. You know, it sounds easy. You think, wow, okay, that's all you gotta do. But you go to lake, guys just get intimidated. They're thinking, oh, where do you find them and stuff? Look for the same things you have on lakes that you're very good at, lakes that you catch them at. But you can't beat small grubs, but it's just matching the hatch. What I mean by that is not just, you know, the baits choices and stuff, but the color, depending on the color of the water and stuff. Here it's relatively clear. I can probably see down 4 or 5 feet. So the weeds grow up high. I want to take advantage of those fish cruising the weed lines. So I'm going to cast out the jig like I normally do, but with two presentations. Cast out, let it hop up, or cast out, retrieve real slow, like a small spinnerbait or crankbait. Those bigger walleyes are just roaming around. They see it, they do that. Let's keep going and hopefully get a real big one. Let's go. Now it's time for the Cottage Angler, presented by St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth.
Hey, this week on the Cottage Angler, I'm gonna show you my 2-minute tip for dissecting a little pocket in a main lake. What I'm talking about is finding a little area that has a couple trees down, some grass, some pads, arrowheads and things, a small area on a big lake that can hold some of the biggest bass of your life, smallmouth and largemouth. And what do I use? Soft plastics, striking perfect plastics. The Rage Craw for me, the number one choice. Rodent, game hog. You know why? I can put it in the most nastiest places, not have to worry about it getting hooked up. That's where those big fish live. But what I'll do is, there's a few things to remember. Stay back. Look at your stuff. Look at where the holes are. Look for the shady spots way back inside and put your bait in there. But you cannot take your eyes off it. Do not. It is so imperative, because what you're doing is you're finding those little spots on a big lake where those fish live, where they chill out. And when you put your bait in there, it's an invitation for them just to eat it up. So I'll look at different spots way back in those shady little pockets, way in there. You think, man, it's too shallow for a fish? Never. One thing about largemouth and smallmouth, if their backs are wet, they can live in it. But just slowly dissect it. Hit the end of the tree first. What I like to do is fish the areas real close to me first. And if they're not there, the sun's high, and those fish pull back, well then I'll work it real tight and put it in those real nasty spots. But the key to this is using the right gear. 7-foot heavy action rod, 20-pound test, either braid, fluorocarbon, and I got a 1/4-ounce sliding tungsten sinker. These tour grade are phenomenal. And the Rage Craw, it's a killer choice in those tight little spots on the big lakes that the big fish live.
Tell you another thing about color and walleye. The misconception of matching the hatch when it comes to walleye, for me, I throw it totally out the window. I don't care. Because you know what? The gaudy chartreuses, the pinks, oranges, you name it, the most ridiculous combinations catch walleye. But what does that tell you? It's because they can see it. You know, they just want to see something to eat. You put that where they are, on the right size, depending on what those fish are feeding on, you're going to catch them. It's as simple as that. But you just kind of think about what you're doing. What size jig head? Is it a river situation? Is it lake, weed, rocks? Just matching your tackle. Use what makes you confident in catching those fish. It doesn't matter what you see in the magazines and on TV and what people read in the seminars and stuff. pick colors that you have confidence in because you're gonna catch them with it. There we go. Yep. Feels like a good walleye too. Just in case, he's real good. Whoa, see? A smooth drag. How big are you? Oh, you're just a little buddy. Look at him. Look at him spitting out all that stuff he's been eating, huh? Yeah, I know. You're still a nice walleye, aren't you? Yes, you are. You know why? Because he ate my little swimming grub first thing in the morning. Look at that. Perfect example. On most lakes, those are the ones you're going to eat right there. But I came out here for fun, to catch you boys, give me a thrill. And you are doing that once again. See where he goes? Those big beady white eyes. Now as for size, you know what? The color is very important to me. You know, the blacks, pinks, chartreuse yellows, bright chartreuse yellow, and the sizes. You see, there's different sizes of a quarter, 3/8, 1/16, 1/8. It's the size that counts. Depending on where you're fishing, how you're fishing, and what you're doing. When I'm swimming that grub, I want that bait to fall slow, stay in the strike zone, because you never know where those walleyes are gonna be. If I'm in 9-10 feet of water, the weeds come up 4 or 5 feet, for all I know is they're a foot below the surface chasing perch and stuff. So the longer my bait is falling in that descent to where those weeds are, where I start to retrieve, the better. So you wouldn't wanna go with a real big jig head like this, because what would happen is that jig would fall into the weeds, defeating the purpose. Different sizes depending on a little bit of a chop. 1/4 ounce, color, pink, chartreuse, and blacks. My mainstay when it comes to walleyes with the grubs, either lifting and dropping or swimming it. But you gotta get it right in the zone where the fish are. In this case, the weeds are up about 3 feet over 10. So you gotta let it sink down about 7-8 feet. And you say to yourself, well, how do I know if I'm right down by those weeds? Well, with a smaller jig head like this, two things happen. You gotta be a bit more patient for it going down. It's not gonna get all gummed up in the weeds because it's not a heavy jig head. And with that little tail, that hook is barely sticking out of there, you'll be able to pull it through. And that little reaction sometimes of that jig coming through the weeds, walleye sees that, he's gonna eat it. See what I mean? Walleye right in front of the boat, hey? And a decent one too. Tighten up a bit. Oh, another nice walleye, look at him. Just a gorgeous fish, eh? Oh, look at that one, wow. Just another beautiful walleye. Look at the size, look how nice and chunky they are. You ate it right in front of the boat, eh? Now here's what I do. I look where I am, see? Waypoint's right there, 220, the depth. I pay attention to where I caught the fish. And every day can change. Some days it's in 10 feet, some days 11, like that. Nice chunky fish, but look at his coloration. You know you're sitting right inside the weeds. Let's let him go. Easy, easy, I'm gonna let you go. Ready? Go on, go on back down. Tell your grandma that I'm here to come and eat. I'll catch you, put you on TV, and let you go. Just like that. It ain't magic, putting the right pieces together, just like a great cake. Got all the raw ingredients sitting out there, looks like nothing. Put it together, yummy. And as for hook sets, when you're swimming the grub like that, you don't wanna be just ripping it out of their mouth, okay? Because they gotta come up, pop it, and then eat it, okay? Walleye's notorious for like sucking in their baits and stuff, so sometimes the line will go a little bit slack, but they'll load up on it. So you just wanna put it out, and when you set those medium action rods, just lean back, let that hook find its mark, then set once you get the fish on. It's not a big thing. Put it out, fish loads up, line gets slack, and then it just bends. Lean back, let the hook find its mark, tighten up, set again, you'll put them in the boat. These fish seem a little bit finicky. And when I'm fishing on these edge of these weed beds and on top of the weed and stuff, I want that bait on top of the weeds, okay? So that's an average 4-inch little ridge tail. I take the scissors and take off about, oh, 1/2 inch maybe. Take a little jig head, 1/8 ounce. I just line it up, rig it down, bring it around, and just push it on the jig head like that. Now you've got a real compact little profile, fat little bait, What that does is, with the small weight, it stays in that strike zone above the weed. From the, you know, the higher in the water column those fish are, they're not right down the weeds when you're swimming this bait and stuff. They seem to be aggressive up high. And that little rage tail, that little thumping motion while it's falling, while you're retrieving it, letting it drop, lifting, dropping, swimming it, it does everything. Here comes the cast into the weed about 8 feet. I'm sitting in 12, bring it down the edge, let it sink. See, told ya. Oh boy. I think it's another good one too. Which way are you going, boy? Huh? Oh boy, look at that drag singing. What a sound. I love that sound of the Evercast. Because you know what that is? That's a better sized fish on the end of my line. Look at him. Oh yeah. Come here, you. Yes, sir. You thought you was just gonna grab my grub. Look at him. Pack the abyss. But you know what? I know where they go. So they ain't kidding me. I'm gonna put this bait, once again, right on their home, make them come out, eat my bait, catch them, land them, show them on TV, and let them go. I gotta find exactly where that weed edge comes down. And let it sink, 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 sink. But I'm watching my line all the time for those fish that eat it on the drop. You're there, a small twitch, and just turn the handle. See, when I'm ticking those weeds, I'm not setting hard, I'm leaning back. But you gotta be close to those weeds. A walleye, just love them. Just slowly retrieve. Waypoint. You see how they eat that thing up? Boy, I love those bigger fish, man. Look at them, look at them pull, eh? Let them pull. He ain't going anywhere. Last thing you wanna do is pull that hook out. Where you going, Mr. Walleye? You're up high in that weed edge, weren't you? You gotta get your net ready. Look at him fight, hey? People say the walleyes don't fight. Uh-oh, look how smart he is. Uh-oh, did he go out on the trolling motor? Let's see, where are you? Oh, you're in the net, hey? There's a nice fish. The color of money. In this case, went back to a money color. And that is my favorite little chartreuse with the blue. And that's how you can get them. Right there on a quartus, right color, right species, on the right spots, and you're gonna catch them too. We had a great morning. We'll see you next time on Extreme Angler TV. Stay hooked, get hooked, and pick the right color. Love you, girl. Look at a big, thick back on you. If you want more Extreme Angler, go to our website, extremeanglertv.com, and I'm sure you'll find us on all your popular social networks, YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook, because I know you're gonna like us.